Mount Zona, we have a Star of David, and we're going to segregate it for more relevance. Now, when looking into certain elements of mathematics, we can understand the Star of David theorem, okay, which is comprised of two equal set triangles, or in this case, Pascal's triangles. Now, a Pascal's triangle is where in which each number is the sum of the two numbers directly above it, creating
a pattern,
which is very interesting. But what's even more interesting is that the Star of David is also known as the Seal
of Solomon.
What's missing? The turtles. Where are the Summer turtles? Sausage. Where are the turtles?
Come on, guys, get out of here.
Where are the turtles? Where are they?
The world is coming to an end. I am so happy. A new master has arrived and he is leading those who know to safety. I plan on joining him myself. He's in the hills, near Granite Pass. It's not too late. I've been trying to warn everyone, but no one will listen. Believe me.
Safety is all that we have.
Okay. Good luck.
Jelonia! Jelonia!
Are you lost, friend?
Follow me, sir. Follow me. Together, we can be safe. Follow me. With this
shell,
I am safe from all things.
Follow me and be saved. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me to Jelonia!
Yo, what's good? It's your boy, Wesby Woods. And in this video, you guys, we're going to start understanding certain elements of Chelonian history. And when I mean Chelonian history, I really mean certain elements of sub-pop culture, okay? Like, where they actually come from within elements of their background, okay? Chelonia, mentioned in any element of pop culture, was really originally in Doctor Who. Okay, Doctor Who is really about a doctor who solves mysteries in time, okay? He has a time-traveling machine called the TARDIS. And it's actually a blue telephone booth, which is very interesting.
What's even more interesting is the description of the Chelonian within Doctor Who. It actually says that they were rather unintelligent creatures as a species, like chickens on Earth. Okay, and strands of their DNA could be found in chickens. But what's even more interesting is the technology. They actually had jetpacks and giga kill lasers. Very, very interesting.
But I want you guys to understand and stay focused. Turtles within this aspect of Chelonianism have always been tied to dinosaurs within Red Dead and even birds within Red Dead and in real life. Okay, when you look at the chain within the tree of evolution, birds and other avian, you know, wildlife actually all derive from elements of reptiles and dinosaurs. But that's neither here nor there. I want you guys to understand that Red Dead gives you those dinosaur bone missions for a reason, okay? And it all has to do with certain elements of pop culture. And I will be revealing things as they go, but this is still things that we have learned from GTA 5 and certain elements that have not, you know, revealed themselves yet, but will in the future, okay? The first thing I want you guys to pay attention to is this huge turtle shell worn by the Grand Master of the Chelonian. Now, I want you guys to pay attention to the middle of this design of the shell, because it is an actual perfect hexagon, okay, which is part of the diagram of a Star of David, which is something I mentioned in the last episode, okay. Now, we need to start understanding these diagrams and why these, you know, different shapes all have something to do with each other, okay? we all have to understand exactly why hexagrams and pentagrams are all relevant within these rituals and why they all derive from Greek, okay? I want you guys to understand that Greece and all of their mythologies and even Rome all have certain elements of this mystery, and it all derived from Epsilon and so forth, and they didn't show you guys Perseus for no reason, okay?
Or the Sisyphus Theater, or the Athena 200s from Vice City. The fact is, you guys, is that Chalon, or Chalon, was a nymph in Greek mythology, okay? And she was actually known for missing the wedding of Zeus and Hera. And for her lazy duties, Hermes is the one who banished her from her house and into a lake to turn into a turtle, to wear her house upon her back. And it was at this moment in the story that you need to realize that most of the time, all of these things are one big allegory towards Greek and Roman mythology.